Buongiorno, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. This weekend, we are in Venice for La Biennale di Venezia.
I've put all the Biennale footages in a separate video. In this one though, I will show you how the rest of this Venice trip went. Coming up next.
Welcome back. It's been 2 months since I last flew. It's always nice to be back here.
Self-service boarding.
Buongiorno. So we are getting onto the plane to go to Venice. Buonasera, benvenuto in Italia. We have just arrived in Venice. Right, before you exit the arrivals, you can get the tickets here. So,
what we're gonna do
is we're gonna buy an Aerobus return ticket. When you do that, you can select 2 days plus Aerobus return. That means 2 days of Vaporetto service, unlimited Vaporetto, and return airport bus. That's quite outrageous. Two persons, 96 euros, but you got to pay the price. So when you exit the airport terminal, just keep heading out and go straight on to go for the bus station. So we just arrived at Hilton Garden Inn. Have stayed here a few times. So this is the hotel we stay in, Hilton Garden Inn. So we've just arrived at Venice. And if you arrive here by bus, you will also see this bridge. This is Ponte de Calatrava. Ponte de Calatrava is a luminous glass and steel bridge that cost triple the original estimate cost of 4 million euros to construct. So we just got to Venice. The first thing to do, well, is actually to visit Co-op. Look at all the Pandoro and Panettone, of course, but I don't like racing, so I like Pandoro. This is the reason we timed the trip at this time of the year. Okay, just arrived at the hotel in Venice. This hotel is called Il Moro. It's a bit too early to check in, but it's great to leave the luggage here for now.
Having left our luggage at the hotel, we can now go out and explore Venice.
The last time we visited Venice was in 2020 July, kind of in the middle of the pandemic, and it was really quiet. But 2 years later, it's absolutely packed, loads of tourists again. So we tried to get the Vaporetto number 2, but we couldn't even get on the first ferry. It's ridiculous, the queue is really long. We saw number 1 passing by, and it's relatively empty. So we are going to walk across to the stop for Vaporetto number 1. Magnum. Why, when you have perfect gelato? Look at the canals. This is what Venice is about. So, Vaporetto number 1 is just coming through. Okay, here we go. Second time lucky. We crossed the bridge to get Vaporetto number 1 and it's a lot less crowded. The 3.5 kilometers Vaporetto route number 1 is the best way to experience the Grand Canal. It passes through over 15 palazzi, which means mansions, and 6 churches. So we're just coming up to the Rialto Bridge now. Ponte di Rialto is probably Venice's most iconic site. The shops were added later as an addition. The peasant bridge was designed by Antonio da Ponte and it cost the modern equivalent of 20 million euros to build. So we're just passing the Academia Bridge now.
Okay, we are approaching the stop San Marco. We are gonna get off the Rapporetto here.
Behind me is the Basilica's Campanini. It's 99 meters tall, and this was where Galileo Galilei tested his telescope in 1609. Up there, you have very good views of the whole St. Mark's Square, but usually there's a very long queue to get in. We're not gonna do that today. Italy has lots of beautiful Gothic buildings, but the Palazzo Ducale is by far the most captivating. The seat of the Doge for almost 1,000 years. As you can see, there's always a long queue for the Palazzo Ducale. Currently, there is an exhibition by Anselm Kiefer, but even without the exhibition, it's always like this. So if you want to visit this palace, but do not want to queue, I think the trick is to get the tickets online beforehand. Then you won't have to queue like this for hours. So next to the Palazzo Ducale is the famous Bridge of Sighs, Ponte de Sospiri. Basilica di San Marco was constructed in 832 to house the body of St. Mark. Allegedly, in AD 828, wily Venetian merchants smuggled St. Mark's corpse out of Alexandria in Egypt in a barrel of pork fat to avoid inspection by Muslim authorities. And for almost 1,000 years, this place served as the Doge private chapel and the city's spiritual heart. The original basilica was burned down in an uprising, but the Venetians rebuilt it twice, and the current incarnation was completed in 1094. It has the most exotic hybrid of Western and Byzantine architecture. Look at these exterior details outside. The transfer of the body of St. Mark to the basilica above the leftmost door is one of the most interesting pieces. So this is St. Mark Square. The last time we came to Venice was summer 2020, when it was, you can say, probably in the middle of the pandemic, and there was hardly any crowd at all. But 2 years on, everything's back to normal, including all the massive crowd around. Here are some pictures of St. Mark's Square from that trip. If you enjoyed watching this video, please give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel with notification on, then you won't miss another video from me. So we are on our way to lunch now. We are going to go to a place called Dal Moro. It's kind of a fast food pasta place. Every time we come to Venice, we go there because the food is really delicious and it's very cheap compared to all the overpriced restaurants around. So this is Dal Moro's, and we always have lunch here whenever we visit Venice. So this is the menu at Dal Moro's. So this one is the Padovana, and this one is the Romana. Basically, it's a spaghetti carbonara, I think. So this pasta is really delicious. So here is one of the many places you can take the gondola ride. Looks like the tariff for 2022 is 80 euro per gondola. So this is very exciting time now. We are approaching Gelateria Susso. It's one of my favorite gelateria in Venice. They serve really, really good gelato there. Here it is, Gelateria Susso. And I'll have a cup as well. I will have Mane, the pistachio al sale and gianduva. And I will have a Susso then. So this is my gelato. I think a gelato with the canal behind. more quintessential Italian experience. Look at chocolate floating down the Ponte di Rialto. So we are now on the Rovereto to get to Giardini for the Biennale.
I've put all the Biennale footages in a separate video. You can watch that by clicking the link above or at the end of the video when there will be a link to that video too. So we are finished with the Giardini part of the Biennale. We'll go to the Arsenale side tomorrow. Now is the time to go to the dinner restaurant.
So this is Cardoro again. So we just got the Vaporetto back to Rialto station, and we booked a restaurant via the Fork, and it over 20% off, and it offers Canal Fun Thrill. Sounds too good to be true. Well, we are gonna find out. So this is the restaurant we're eating at, Ristorante Omnibus. And these are the tables, and we got the table right here. You can see right by the canal front. Right, the dinner has arrived. I have the pescato, the giornale, the fish of the day. They have warned me it's a bit small, but actually I think it's all right. It's not that bad. It's a reasonable size. Buon appetito.
So mine's arrived as well. A fillet of chicken and an assortment of grilled vegetables. Looks nice. Let's get going.
Right, we just had the dinner and it was reasonably good, and well, the view can't be beaten, so overall is okay. It's a little bit expensive even after the 20% discount, but well, we're in Venice. What do we expect? This is Venice at night. It's equally beautiful. Look at all the reflection on the canal. Buongiorno, it's Sunday today and we are going to Biennale again. It's 10 o'clock on Sunday. We are heading to Arsenale now.
Here, we have a bridge called Ponte del Purgatorio. The name is an homage to the great Florentine poet Dante Alighieri. In the Inferno of his Divina Commedia, he evoked an image of the Venice Arsenale to explain the punishment reserved for swindlers, the immersion in a boiling pitch.
So we just arrived at the Arsenale area, but here there's a very impressive monument that we got to stop and have a look. Apparently the lion there is the Piraeus lion that come from Greece actually. It's a very impressive monument here. We're now at the entrance to the Arsenale. This looks like almost like a fortress to me.
The Arsenale is a symbol of power of the old Venetian Republic. This was the shipyard where army and merchant ships were constructed. We're now at the entrance for the Biennale. So again, we'll skip ahead to when we leave the exhibition.
Looks like there's a regatta going on. You can see a flotilla of yachts. It's very busy here and very pretty, all these gondola poles and these really pretty gondolas. In front of me is the Bridge of Sighs, but looking from the other direction. Usually, we will see it from the other side.
Okay, let's go take the Vaporetto to our final destination in Venice.
So, right now we're in St. Giorgio Maggiore. Yesterday, I was on the Vaporetto number 1, and I met this really nice American couple, and they asked me if there is any special place in Venice that is worth visiting. They were going to go on a cruise after today, and I mentioned to them this place where I am, St. Giorgio Maggiore. The view from the bell tower of St. Giorgio Maggiore is probably the city's finest. And the church, dazzling marble facade, provides one of the great panoramic set pieces of the Venetian skyline. As you can see from here, you get a really good sweeping panorama of the whole city, including St. Mark's Square and the Campanile. Instead of queuing for hours to get on top of the Campanile, why not visit this St. Giorgio Maggiore instead?
Here are some photos from the top of the Campanile of St. Giorgio Maggiore from a previous trip.
If you enjoyed watching this video, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel with notifications on. That way you will never miss another episode of video from me. So right now in St. Giorgio Maggiore, there is an exhibition by Ai Weiwei, La Commedia Umana. Composed of more than 2,000 individual pieces handcrafted by the glass maestro of Berengo Studio in Murano, La Commedia Umana is an enormous artwork of colossal dimensions, more than 6 meters wide and almost 9 meters high, making it the largest hanging sculpture ever made in Murano glass in living history.
La Commedia Umana is the result of the collaboration of Ai Weiwei and the masters of Berengo Studio. The sculpture is a glass assemblage of mythological figures, human skulls, skeletons, internal organs, bones, bats, crabs, and unexpected objects like surveillance cameras. The exhibition also includes 30 significant works of Ai Weiwei, many of them created in Lego bricks, which the artist has been using since 2007 as an art medium. This one is a recreation of Sleeping Venus, originally by Giorgione and Titan.
It's amazing, it's a scream. Here's another masterpiece that Ai Weiwei made using Lego blocks.
This one is a recreation of Illumination, which is an iconic selfie taken by the artist in Chengdu in 2009 when police escorted him to a hotel lift. The next one is a recreation of his provocative photographic artwork, Dropping a Han Dynasty Urn. The original photos documented him holding, dropping, and standing over the remains of a 2,000-year-old Han Dynasty urn. The final Lego recreation is his Zodiac series with saturated colors that make them look like Andy Warhol's paintings. Here are photos of his original Zodiac series, which I saw in Palm Springs Art Museum in March 2015. The 12 animal heads were originally part of a water clock in the Old Summer Palace in Beijing.
So we were going to go up to the Campanile to have a look at the panorama, but because of the very interesting Ai Weiwei exhibition, we just realized we don't really have time and we now have to go back to the hotel, get our luggage and go to the airport.
Overall, we had a great visit to Venice. The Biennale was really good this year. We thoroughly enjoy it, and it's always great to return to Venice to revisit the old sites. On that note, I will end the video here. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Ciao!